This is JP from Naughty Lights over Arkham. This time I will be playing my blind playthrough through the Barkham Horror, the Meddling of Meowlathotep scenario. And I haven't played the scenario before, so this will be interesting and new to me too. So, because at the moment I can't make the decks in Arkham DP, so I don't have a deck list at hand for the decks I'm using, so I'll just actually throw a couple of decks together, and I won't go into detail what's in the decks. You just can make basically any kind of deck and try it out when you hopefully get the Barkham Horror expansion. So, first let's look at our investigators who we are using. So, the lead investigator will be Duke. Duke is the good boy. Duke has 2 willpower, 4 intellect, 4 fight, and 2 agility. He is a drifter. You may begin the game with a friendly human in play, and of course the friendly human is, I guess his name is Pete, question mark, and with the friendly human it has 5 treats on it. So after you succeed at a skill test, spend 1 treat. Good boy either choose 1 heal, 1 damage, or 1 horror, draw 1 card, or gain 1 resource. So that is quite useful. And there are 5 treats on the friendly human at the start. Then we have a double action. You beg for more treats, place 3 treats on friendly human. And the elder sign effect is plus 2, place 1 treat on friendly human after this test ends, ready him. Okay. And I will mention quickly about the deck building rules. So Duke is a survivor with 0 to 5 survivor cards, 0 to 5 level neutral cards, and up to 5 other ally 0 cards who are either other dogs or humans who want to pet you. So I'm still not quite sure how I feel about this weird deck building restrictions, because they let a lot slide. Let's quickly look at the Kate Winthpup's the labrador's deck building before we look at the card more. There are seeker cards 0 to 5, neutral cards 0 to 5, up to 5 other level 0 cards that look like they would smell weird. So how do you interpret a card that might smell weird? Well, there are no guidelines to that anywhere. So I think because this is a novelty and just for fun scenario, you shouldn't take this too seriously. So I'm going with that. So I'm not taking this in any way seriously and just having fun. Kate Winthpup is the laboratory labrador, and the reason actually for picking up Kate for my blind playthrough is that my dog is a labrador, so of course I had to pick the labrador. And she has 3 willpower, 4 intellect, 1 fight, and 4 agility. She is a scholar and a pup. While you are at a location you've sniffed, each skill test you perform gets minus 1 difficulty. Action: sniff your location or a connecting location. This action does not provoke attacks of opportunity. An elder sign effect, plus 0, sniff your location or a connecting location. And because the guide book tells you to put resources on the locations you've sniffed, but I feel like I want to use something special, I'm actually using these cool new bless tokens, which I just got in preparation for the InSmart Conspiracy. So I will be placing these onto the locations which are sniffed. And that will mark that they are sniffed. Then let's look quickly at the scenario before we start. So we have these cards underneath some of these locations. They are they are Miovsk enemies, which are some kind of cat monsters, and because they are underneath those cards, those locations are lousy with cats. That doesn't mean anything, but some game effects or I think encounter cards will trigger off of that. Also, the Kate Winthpup card sniffs out locations, so there is a short clarification how that works. So we just place a token under the location. That is it. I think I will read the the intros and the act and agenda once we get started. So without further delay, let's get started and see how this scenario works. Okay, so let's start with the intro. So, the meddling of Meowlathotep. We may indeed judge the tone and bias of civilization by its relative attitude towards dogs and cats. H.P. Lovecraft, Cats and Dogs. Intro 1. It is a dark and stormy night in the storied and haunted city of Barkham. By the time you hit the streets, it is raining cats and dogs. But you've picked up a scent of something big, and once you sink your teeth into a story, you just can't let go. A little wet fur has never stopped you from finding the truth. Strange happenings have been going on in Barkham. Cat sightings are at an all-time high, and each day more and more pigeons go missing. While this wouldn't normally be newsworthy, you know that there is more to this story than meets the eye. After all, while a few cats are harmless and adorable, most are nefarious schemers. You have heard the whispers and the howls of the wind on the wind. The odor of dead rodents on the doorstep is back, and whatever they are plotting, only you can stop it. You're heading back to your home in Slubber Town, the Barkham neighborhood closest to the docks, when you catch a whiff of something foul and pungent in the air. Whatever is causing such an acrid stench must be nearby, but just then another scent. The lead investigator must decide, choose one. Follow the foul stench, proceed to intro 2. Or follow the scent of bacon, skip to intro 3. So, I think... Well, Duke is after treats, so I think we're following the smell of bacon. So we skip to intro 3. The investigation can't wait. Bacon is eternal. You follow the lovely smell northeast of Tuvelma's doghouse in Beast Town. The sounds of revelry and the sizzling of grilled food make your tail wag faster than the cracking of a whip. And yet something else tugs at the back of your dog brain. What was it you were doing before? The lead investigator must decide. Nope, food, skip into intro 3. Oh yeah, investigating the order, skip to intro 7. So I think even that Duke is after the treats, Duke is a really good investigator. So I think Duke decides that the checking out, investigating the order is more important than bacon. So let's go to intro 7. The urgency of your investigation is too important for you to be distracted by thoughts of that tasty food. As you turn away from Velma's, you spot a streak of cat fur dipping gracefully out of sight. Using your keen sense of smell, you keep a tight pursuit as the cat winds its way west to Tailside, where Barkham train station can be found. You follow the cat to the tracks on the western edge of the town. There it ducks underneath an abandoned train car marked with a cat's paw print. Massachusetts Catnip Corporation reads the label beneath the logo. A front for a cult headquarters, no doubt. You are about to eavesdrop on the cat's refuge when suddenly a creature bursts forth from underneath the train. It is a hideous hybrid of bird, bat, and cat, with weeped paws and membranous wings, notably lacking in fur, though its face is unmistakably feline. The sight of the thing makes you makes your fur stand on end. Proceed to set up. You will begin playing Tailside. Okay, so in the setup, we are not told where we start, so this introductions, whatever you decide, will determine where you start. So we are starting in Tailside. So Tailside, where you go when you need to see a dog about a man. So Tailside is a tree shroud location with one Cooper investigator. Past triggered ability. Spend two resources. You pursue a raccoon for no reason. Move to Beast Town. Group limit once per round. So let's put some clues there. And put our investigators here. And we are ready to start. So let's read the agenda. So agenda 1A of cats and dogs. You're hot on the trail of a cat conspiracy. A cat piracy, if you will. A fast trigger ability. Investigators at a location that is lousy with cats spend two clues per investigators as a group at the car beneath that location to the victory display. Action, if you are at a location that is lousy with cats, flip the card beneath that location over and spawn it at that location exhausted. And we have a threshold of 4 doom. Act 1A, 9 lives. So, dogs all across town report seeing strange cats crawling around several locations in Barkham. Perhaps if you investigate these areas, you can root out the cat monsters that dwell within. Objective, at the start of the investigation phase, if no locations are lousy with cats, advance. Okay. I still need to shuffle the deck, so I'll pause the video for a moment while I do the shuffling and we'll start our first turn then. So I'll be right back. Okay. We are ready to draw our opening hands. Let's start with Duke. So we draw 5 cards. So we get the Fire Axe and we get Hair of the Dog. So I'll be reading the new cards that come in with Arkham Horror pack. So the others are all the cards that are available in Arkham Horror, but the Barkham cards are new. So let's see what they are. Hair of the Dog, it's a skill for wild icons. Barkham deck only. Max 1 committed per skill test. After this skill test ends, the investigator performing the test gets minus 2 skill value to the next skill test they perform this round. So it's a really good card, but you should only commit it to the last skill test. We have Resourceful, we have Lucky, and we have Fight or Flight. So at the moment, I think I have a weapon. So I think I'll mulligan the rest. So let's see what we get. Well, we get the newspaper, and we get the Stunning Blow, and another Resourceful. So it's an okay hand. We have something to help us investigate better and something to fight with. So that is a decent starting hand. And then we get the Kate's cards. So there is also one copy of Hair of the Dog in Kate's deck. We also get Encyclopedia and Hawkeye Folding Camera. We also get the new card Dog Monocle. It's a 2-cost asset with one intellect icon, item tool, classy, Barkham deck only. You get plus one intellect while investigating and also plus one skill value during a parley action. Because, I mean, honestly, look at you. Memes haven't been invented yet. And it's a accessory slot asset and also gives plus two willpower. So I think I'm keeping the Monocle, Encyclopedia, and I think I'm keeping the whole hand. Because why not? Well, I think let's see what we get instead of Shortcut. So we get Inquiring Mind. Okay, and let's start playing. So, I think I'll start with Duke. So, Duke plays the Fire Axe and the newspaper. And I think I will investigate for the last action. And I won't commit anything. We are investigating with the newspaper 6 versus 3. And it's a skull. And skull is X, where X is half of the number of Meowsk enemies in play in the victory display and attached to Meowlathotep rounded up. So it's a 0 at the moment. So if we succeed, we get one clue. And then we'll spend one treat from the friendly human to draw one card. And we get a glimmer of hope. And that is Duke's turn done. We'll go to Kate. So we are just setting up. I think I'll play the Encyclopedia. It comes into play with 5 secrets. So this is the Encyclopedia level 0 that came in Harvey Walters' Investigator Starter deck. And I think I'm also playing the Hawkeye Folding Camera. And the last action, I just investigate. I am investigating. I'm using one charge from the Encyclopedia. So I'm investigating 6 versus 3. It's a minus 4, so unfortunately we fail, but nothing I can do. So that was both of the investigator's turns. So no enemies, we go to upkeep, we draw a card, we get field work, and we get resourceful, and both dogs get a resource. So that was the first turn. Let's go to the next turn. Okay, so the first Mythos phase starts. We add one Doom to the agenda. Duke draws the first encounter card, and it is Case of the Ceiling Cat. Terror. Revelation test willpower 5. For each point you fail by, either lose one resource or choose a discard one card from your hand. If this effect forces you to lose all of your resources and discard all of your cards, you feel really creeped out. Okay. So let's see. Do I have any good cards to commit? I feel like I don't. Well, I'm committing the Glimmer of Hope. I can lose some resources. It's fine. We don't have anything expensive to play at the moment. So I'm just testing 3 versus 5. And it's of course it's an auto fail. Okay, well, we have to discard, well, we discard 4 resources. Then I'll discard 1 I'll discard Stunning Blow. Why not? We don't have any enemies yet. Kate's card is Muse of Meowlathotep Power Revelation. If Meowlathotep is in play, it attacks each investigator in a play order. If at least one location is lousy with cats, choose one of those locations, flip the card beneath that location over and spawn it at that location. Neither is true, this card gains search, so we have to flip one of those cards over. Let's think about this for a bit. I think we'll start from the boneyard, so this card gets flipped over, and it's the ghost cat. So, it's a unique card. It has 2 fight, 2 health, and 4 evade. It is a creature, Miov's Elite Alert Hunter. This enemy gets plus 1 health per investigator, so it has 4 health. Action, if you buried the bones a few meters from where you found them, parlay. Oh, that's what those were. Well, that's sad. Still, the cat spirit is appeased. Add this enemy to the victory display. It's a victory one. Okay, so there's a parlay. And how appropriate that this spawned in the boneyard. Oh, and I am not using location connectors because each location is connected to the card on each side. So also like this. So I would have run out of connection location connectors, and it would clunk up the board. So we can just move freely from location to the other. Okay, so that was the mythos phase. We go to the investigation phase. First action, I think I will investigate with Kate again. I am investigating six. I'm using the encyclopedia, so I'm again investigating six versus. Before that, I'll actually play the monocle. So we play the dog monocle. So we are investigating seven versus four. Seven versus three. And it's an autofail. We'll just investigate again. So we're still investigating 7 versus 3. Oh my god. Come on, last action. Maybe I can pull something else than the autofail for the last one. Okay, so it's a minus 2, so finally we get this clue. And we get one charge on the camera, so we have a plus 1 to willpower too. And that's Kate's turn. And then we go to Duke. Well, so we still need 2 clues to flip one of those cards and defeat it. So this guy has a hunter, so it starts moving, so we'll just next turn try to kill it. And I think we'll move to... Let's go to Beast Town with Duke. So, Beast Town. Be cautious where you walk in Beast Town. You never know what you might step in. So it's a 2-shroud location with 1 clue per investigator. Action, fast action, trigger ability, spend 2 resources. You follow a weird scent heading south. Move to Slubber Town. Group limit once per round. So there are ways to move more faster in these central locations, I bet. So second action, I will investigate 4 versus 2. I'll commit resourceful to the test. So 5 versus 2. it's a tablet. So tablet is minus two. If you fail, place one of your clues on your location. So we don't fail, we get the clue. And resourceful triggers, so I think I'll grab the stunning blow. And last action, I'll just investigate again. And I'm investigating 4 versus 2. And auto fail. Well, so that's, I think, 4 auto fails in 2 rounds. So, yeah. This isn't going that well. Well, that's the investigation phase. We go to enemy phase. The ghost cat moves to. Let's see. Let's move to Slobber Town. Okay, so that's the enemy phase. We go to upkeep. We draw a card. We gain deduction. We gain 1 resource. Draw a card. We get hired dog. So this is a new card again. So because Duke can take allies that are dogs or humans that would pet dogs, so I just pick the hired dogs. So we have a fast triggered ability during a turn, exhaust hired dogs, fight, investigate, either attack with base skill of 4 or investigate with base skill of 4. After this test ends, either pay 1 resource in dog food or discard hired dogs. So that's a decent card. And yeah, I could have used the. Yeah, I failed. I got 1 clue, so I could have used friendly human, but I forgot. So that is that. And that's the turn done. So let's go to the next turn. We are at 2 Doom of 4. Duke's encounter card is. It's the Stubborn Cat. Hazard. Revelation attached to the location in play with the most clues. It is the Beast Town. A cat is laying on all of the evidence at this location. You obviously cannot investigate at that location. Test willpower 4 or agility 4 to shoo the cat away. If you succeed, discard Stubborn Cat. Okay, so I'll just put it here. And Kate's card is Scratching Paws. Test agility 3. For each point you fail by, take 1 damage. So I think I'm just testing 4 versus 3. And it's the elder thing. It's a minus 5. Woof. Okay, so we take 3 damage. So this isn't going that well. And we only have 2 health remaining. This could be a short game. But it is what it is. Yeah. Unbelievable. I think I'll start with Kate. I'll use Kate's ability to sniff a location or a connecting location. So I think I'll sniff the Barkham Asylum. Or actually I'll first move. I move to the university. So the university, it's Mutskatonic University. It's a 4 shroud location with 1 clue per investigator. Action draw 3 cards, limits once per game. Action discard cards from your hand with a total of at least 3 intellect skill icons on them. Remember that you brushed up on a cat physiology. Okay. Now we'll sniff out the. I'll sniff out the university. And last action, I'll move to the St. Mary's Hospital. St. Mary's Animal Hospital. So, we're going for a car ride, they said. It'll be fun, they said. So it's a three shard location with two clues per investigator. Action heal 3 damage. You're not happy about it though, limit once per game. So I think Kate is doing that next turn. Action take 1 damage, parlay test intellect 4 to schedule a visit to the vet for a cat. This is physically painful for you. If you succeed, remember that the cat has an appointment with the vet. Okay. Just finding these cards hilarious. So that is Kate's turn done. We'll go to Duke. I think this turn Duke will go and fight the ghost cat. So we'll move to... Actually, I could spend 2 resources, which I don't have. But I'll just move to Slubber Town. So the banks of Muskatonic River are lined with warehouses and stores, filled with exotic treats from all around the world. So Slubber Town is a 3 shard location with 1 clue per investigator. Fast trigger ability, spend 2 resources, Barkham has no leash laws. You take yourself to a walk, move to snout side. Okay, crude limit once per phase, per round. And this ghost cat engages us. And we will fight. I'll use the fire axe, so I'm fighting 6 versus 2. And it's a plus 1. We deal 2 damage. And last action, we'll fight again. And just to be sure, I'll use the hair of the dog. So I'm fighting 8 versus 2. And it's a skull. So we defeat the ghost cat and it goes into the victory display. So I put it over this side. And that is to Duke's turn, so enemy phase, nothing happens, we go to upkeep. We draw a card, we get the shortcut and 1 resource. And we get another newspaper and 1 resource. So that is that turn, let's go to the next turn. We are at 3 doom of 4. Duke's encounter card is Rodent Killer. It's a 3 fight, 3 health and 3 evade humanoid cultist. Prey investigator nearest to a card that is lousy with cats. And it's a hunter. So it spawns on Duke, so let's put it over here. And Kate's card is hunted by Biocats. Revelation put hunted by Biocats into play in the threat area. As an additional cost to perform any of the following actions, move, fight, or investigate, you must spend 1 resource in cat food to appease the person Biocats. Forced at the end of your turn, test intellect 3. If you succeed, discard hunting by Biocat. So, move, fight, investigate. We have to spend resources. Okay. I think I'm starting with Kate. So, first action will heal 3 damage. Second action, I will use deduction to investigate here. I'm investigating. And I'll use the encyclopedia too. I'm investigating 7 versus 8 versus 3. And it's a tablet, so it's a minus 2, so we get 2 clues. And yeah, so we need to... Yeah, we need to spend the one resource to investigate. We'll just investigate again. And I think I'm fine just investigating. So 5 versus 3. 7 versus 3 with the encyclopedia. It's a 0. We get another clue. And so, as a fast trigger ability, I'll spend 4 clues on this location. So, add the Kirby in that location to the victory display. So, we get rid of this card. And let's see what it is. It's the Cat of Tyndalus. It's a 2 fight, 3 health, and 3 evade. Monster Musk Elite. Hunter retaliate, this enemy gets plus 1 health per investigator. If you possess a ball of yarn, parlay, you throw the ball of yarn into the perfect 90 degree corner. Cat of Tyndalus predictably follows it into an extra-dimensional pocket. Add this card to the victory display. But we already managed to add it with the trigger ability. So that's Kate's turn done. At the end, we'll test the intellect test. It's intellect 3, so I'll use the inquiring mind for this test. So we are testing 7 versus... Oh yeah, an encyclopedia. So 9 versus 3. And it's a minus 5, we still succeed. So good thing we used that, so we get rid of this one. We go to Duke. So Duke has this enemy. I think first action we'll just hit. We'll use the stunning blow. We are hitting 5 versus 3. It's a minus 4, we fail. God damn it. We'll hit again and use the charge. So 6 versus 3. Auto fail. What can we do? I think we'll just have to try and hit again. I'll commit the resourceful. So 5 versus 3. It's a plus 1, so we hit and we'll get the stunning blow back into our hand. We'll deal 2 damage to the rodent killer. And we succeed, so let's get 1 resource. And we go to the enemy phase. The Ronin killer hits. It hits for 1 damage and 1 horror. I'll take it on Duke. That's the enemy phase. We go to upkeep. We draw a card. We get the feline discombobulator. It's a 2 cost asset with the intellect, agility, and wild icon. Item science, Kate Winthpup deck only. Pre-triggered ability. Pre-triggered ability. When an enemy would spawn at your location, if that enemy is a cat, looks like a cat, or is some kind of weird cat person, hybrid exhaust feel and discombobulator automatically evade it. Well, maybe not useful. We get Duke. One resource, and Duke's card is it's fight or flight, and we gain 1 resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. So we are at 4 doom of 4, so the agenda advances. Okay. So, cats out of the bag. The summoning is complete. Now one of the myriad Meowlathotep of the provels the streets of Barkham It is up to you to put an end to this menace before its true master is unveiled. If no locations are lousy, it gets advanced to Agenda 2A. If at least one location is lousy, it gets find the one that is farthest from all investigators, flip the card beneath that location over and spawn it at that location, reset the agenda deck to Agenda 1A. Okay, so we reset that to Agenda 1A, and the farthest Lausivis cats is the Velma's doghouse. So we flip this over, we get the hisser in the dark, the cat that came back. It's a 3 fight, 4 health and 3 agility, evade Monster Musk elite enemy, alert hunter. This enemy gets plus 1 health per investigator, so it has 6 health. Post, while the Hissler in the dark is engaged with you, if you enter and leave each of the central location in one turn, it becomes extremely dizzy. Add it to the victory display. Okay. So, that's the agenda advancing resetting, so we get the encounter card. So, Duke gets Cats in the Mist. Death will power 3. For each point you fail by, to take 1 horror. And the fluff text is quite hard to read. Well, it reads meow in the middle. Maybe that's anything that it really reads. So I'm testing willpower 2 versus 3. I don't have anything to boost it with, so I'll just test it. And it's a tablet. If you fail, place one of your clues onto your location. Oh yeah, and I think we have forgotten to add the clues here. Yeah. We haven't investigated here, so we drop one of our clues on this location, which is a shame. And we take 3 horror. 1 goes to friendly human and 2 goes to Duke. Then Kate's card is scratching paws. Oh my god, hopefully this time we can succeed. So I'm actually committing the feline decompopulator to this test because we already have an accessory slot item in play. I'm testing 6 versus 3. Hopefully we don't take any damage this time. It's a minus 1, so we are fine. Those paws are really sharp looking. Yeah, this art on these cards is so funny. Investigation phase. Let's start with Duke. So Duke hits the rodent killer. Do I want to boost this in any way? I think I'm playing the fight or flight. So we get the plus 3 to our fight and evade. And we get a skull, so it's minus 2 because we have 3 of those in play or in victory display. So still we hit and kill off the rodent killer. And we succeeded a test. We'll use that to draw. We'll gain a resource. We'll investigate. I'm investigating. I'll commit the newspaper. I'm investigating 5 versus 3. Another auto fail. I can't believe this. I'll just investigate. 4 versus 3. Minus 2, so we fail. Okay, well, that is Duke done, so we go to Kate. First action, I think I'll just investigate here. Investigating 5 versus three, five versus three, so it's a cultist, it's a minus two. If you fail, place one doom on the nearest enemy, but we succeed, so we get this clue. We also get one charge onto the camera. Second action, I'll move back to the Miskatonic University. And I'll do this. So I discard cards from your hand with the total of at least three intellect skill icons on them. Remember that you brushed up on cat physiology, and I'll use the hair of the dog for that. So we remember that we've done that. And that is our turn, so enemy phase, this guy hunts. Let's hunt here. And draw a card, gain a resource, draw a card, gain a resource. Okay, so that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another doom onto the agenda. It's 1 of 4. The encounter card for Duke is another rodent killer. Okay, so we know what Duke's... Yeah, this guy should be dead. So we know what Duke is doing this turn. Killing another rodent killer. Kate's card is... Servant of Doxotot. Okay. So it's a 2-fight-4 health and 2 evade monster cut abomination. Spawn location with the most enemies, including face down and counter cards, alert, retaliate. So location with the most enemies can be... It's actually a Barkham Asylum, because there are this and this face down card here. So we'll spawn it there. Well, lucky it didn't spawn on Kate. And that guy doesn't even have Hunter, so it just stays there. We can start our investigation phase, so I think first action is that Duke will hit the Ronin killer. I'll commit the stunning blow to the test. I'm hitting 5 versus 3. I'll spend one resource from the fire axe, so 7 versus 3. It's a cultist, it's a minus 2, so I succeed. I will do 1 damage, and I will also stun the enemy. And I succeed, so I'll just get one resource. I'll on my second action, I'll play the Hired Dogs, just because it's a new card. Well, yeah, let's do that. I think the better play would be play the Guard Dog, but I want to try this out. Last action will hit. And I'll commit the guard dog to the test. I'm hitting the rodent killer 5 versus 3. It's minus 2, so we hit and kill it off. Okay. Well, Duke's killing cats left and right. Or defeating them. Let's say that we are not actually killing them. Because even if I'm a dog person, I still like cats. Kate's turn. I think I'm going to play fieldwork. Second action, I will investigate. I'm investigating, and there's a sniff counter here, so I'm investigating. Let's see. So we get a minus one difficulty. So we are investigating 4, 5, 6 versus 3. And that's good enough. I'm not using the encyclopedia this time. It's a minus 3, so we succeed. We get one clue. And last action, we'll investigate again. It's a minus 5, so we fail. Oh well. Enemy phase, this guy hunts here. Upkeep. We draw a card and gain a resource. Draw a card, gain a resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. Okay, let's add another Doom. Dukes and counter card is. Cats in the Mist again. Oh dear. I have to commit the Glimmer of Hope to this test in hopes to get the, not get that much horror. Well, we have the hard dogs that can soak some horror, which is okay. Let's see what we get. It's minus 3. So we're testing the 3 versus 3, so minus 3 we still take 3. Not getting a break, so take one here and two here. I'm one away from getting defeated by horror. Oh yeah, was checking something from the Kate card. Let's put it back. Kate counter card is Scratching Paws. Well, yeah, I'm just testing it. Testing 4 versus 3. And auto fail. Well, surprise, surprise. 3 damage. I think this will be my record auto fail tentacle pull game for now. I think I've pulled like I'll add definitely a auto fail counter to this test in editing. But yeah. Let's continue. So let's start with Kate. I will investigate. I'm investigating I'll investigate 6 versus 3 because of the sniff counter here. It's a skull, it's a minus 2. It's a minus 3. No, it's a minus 2. So we still succeed. We get this clue. And we will crack the case. We'll get 4 resources. And I will use the fieldwork. Move to snow side. And it's a one shot location with one clue per investigator. And we'll just investigate here again. 6 versus. Six versus one. I don't think we need to boost that anyway. We actually get one counter here too. Forgot about that. It's a minus 3, so we succeed. We get this one too. And I'll use shortcut to move back here. And I'll spend the clues. And we'll put this guy here to the victory display. So it's the Dweller in the Deep. It's a 3-5, 3 health and 2 evade monster Musk Elite Alert Hunter. This enemy gets plus 1 health per investigator. If you crossed up on cat physiology, parlay, you inform the Dweller in the Deep that it has no gills and therefore cannot breathe underwater. The universe self-corrects for the paradox and the dweller in the deep ceases to exist. Added to the victor display. Okay. Well, I think last action I'll just play the higher education down. Just put it there. And that is our turn for Kate, and we'll go to Duke. Well, I think Duke wants to move here, investigate a 4-1 auto fail. Oh my god, so many auto fails. Last action, investigate. -3, so at least we got this clue. And that is our turn. Enemy base, this guy hunts here. Upkeep. Draw a card. Gain resources. That is that turn. So let's go to the next turn. So exciting. Let's see if Duke can survive the next encounter card. Yeah, we add a doom here again. So, an estranged cat. It's a 3-5-1 health 2 evade creature. Spawn any empty location. Force after estranged cat enters play, place one doom on it. When an estranged cat could be defeated, it runs away to the discard pile, but isn't injured at all. Please, I'm not a monster. Okay, so let's spawn it to an empty location. Let's just spawn it in the boneyard because Duke is heading there. Encounter card for this turn is okay, it is another strange cat. So Well, I'll just spawn it to St. Mary's Hospital. Okay, we'll start with Duke. We'll move to the boneyard. So, boneyard is both dogs and ghouls agree bones are delicious. Boneyard, it's a one-shot location with two clues per investigator. After you successfully investigate boneyard by two or more, place one resource on boneyard as a bone. What do you expect? If there are one bones per investigator on boneyard, nice, that's a lot of bones, remove them and remove that. Remember that you buried the bones a few meters from where you found them. Well, I think we don't have to do that because we already defeated the newest enemy that cares about that. So there are four clues here. And this cat engages us and we'll fight. I'm hitting. Actually, I'll fight with the hired dogs. So I'm fighting 4-3 as a fast trigger ability. So we need to exhaust these hired dogs. And it's an elder sign for once. So +2, place 1 treat on friendly human. After this test ends, ready him. Well, it's already readied and there's no text to exhaust this guy. So we hit, we kill it, but it doesn't get defeated, it just runs the victory display. I know, into the discard pile. And second action, we'll move here. This guy engages, then we will... Oh yeah, and I'll actually heal one horror. then last action will hit. I'll spend one resource. It's a minus four. So we are six versus three. So we are failing, but I'll use lucky. So we succeed. So this guy is also runs into the discard pile. And that, yeah, and I'll again heal one horror. And we are out of treats, we need more treats. Maybe next turn. Okay, we'll go to Kate. First two actions. I'll move, and I'll use field work to move again. And we'll move to here. So we are at the Barkham City Pound. You ain't nothing but a pound dog. And it's a three shroud location with two clues per investigator. Action gain through resources, limit once per game. Action spend one resource, parlay, test the agility four to convince the employees to part with some cat toys by acting adorable. If you succeed, remember that you possess a ball of yarn. Again, we don't need that. I think, yeah, because we defeated the cat of Tindalus already. I think we're investigating here and trying to get rid of this from underneath here. And that is Kate's turn. Enemy phase. One, two, one. Oh yeah, forgot this is connected. So this guy comes and engages us. And we could have moved. Okay, let's back up a bit. So we moved. One, two, and field worker, and we could still investigate for our last action. So we'll do that before we go to the enemy phase. It's an elder sign. So sniff your location or a connecting location. I'll sniff this location. Okay, we get one clue. And now this guy moves here and engages us. So let's see. It hits us for one damage and one horror. Oh no. That's not good. Well, let's see what we can do. So we go to upkeep. We draw a card. Okay, well, this helps. So, occult invocation. As an additional cost to play occult invocation, discard two cards from your hand. Oh no, I need more cards. Fight. This attack uses intellect instead of fight. You get plus one intellect and deal plus one damage for this attack for each card discarded as part of this cost. Oh yeah, so up to two cards. Okay. Okay, well, we'll see when we get there if we can hit that guy with that. Yeah, we get the resource. And we get the card. We get the 18 Derringer, and we get the resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 4 doom of 4, so again this ready flips. So the farthest location with Lousy with Cats is this one. We flip that card and spawn it there and reset this. So it's the Pouncer in the Night, Nocturnal Hunting Cat. 4 fight, 2 health and 2 evade. Humanoid Meowsk Elite Hunter retaliate, this enemy gets plus one health per investigator. Action, if a cat has an appointment with the vet, parlay. What? Oh, Heck no. The cat flees in absolute terror at this enemy to the victory display. Okay, so I think Duke could make an appointment, and then this guy is easier to defeat, but let's see. Encounter card, so Duke gets Gaze of Ceiling Cat, so it's a willpower test. We have nothing to boost it with, so we'll just test it. Minus two, so we fail. We have to discard five cards and all resources, so we discard one card and one resource, and we feel creeped out, which doesn't mean anything actually, at least what I know. So Kate's card is hunted by fire cats. Okay, so we have to pay for move, fight, or investigate actions, and we test if we get rid of that. So I think I'll try to do that with Duke. I'll take one damage. I'll test 4 versus 4 intellect. Yeah. Actually, first action I'll draw a card. Okay. Second action I'll use that. And now I'll take the damage. So 5 versus 4. It's a minus one, so we successfully get appointment for the cat or the vet. Last action. We'll move here. And Kate is in a bit of a pinch, so I think I'll use the encyclopedia to boost my agility. So I'm agility 4 plus 2, so 6. I try to evade. I'm evading 6 versus 3. So it's a minus 3, so we luckily evade this guy. Second action. We'll have to pay 1 to move. I'll move here, and last action, actually, I'll use the field work to move, so I have plus 2 to investigate here, so I'll investigate. It's an elder sign, so we can sniff this location out, do that. Get a clue. And last action, we'll just investigate again. It's a 0, so we get another clue. Okay. That's the investigation phase done. Enemy phase, this guy hunts here. Actually, we'll hunt here. So Duke can go parlay next turn. Then this guy readies. He's ready. We draw a card, we get another shortcut, and a guard dog, and both get resources. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another doom, and Duke's encounter card is Meddling of Meowlathotep. So we still have one location lost in cat, so unfortunately we need to flip that, so yeah, that's unfortunate. So we can't defeat this easily anymore. should be here. So it's the Mewling Hunger, Capricious Twins. It's a 2/5 health, 2 evade humanoid Musk Elite Hunter. This enemy gets +1 health per investigator. Action, if you scored some tasty food parlay, the hungry twins have been placated. They curl up happily in a box and fall asleep at this enemy to the display. Okay, so I think we would need to go to the diner to, or the Velma's doghouse to do that and encounter card for Kate is, oh yeah, we forgot to test that at the end of our round, so I'm just testing 4 versus 3. We fail. Yeah, I think yeah, we lost one resource for investigating, so we get a strange cat that spawns in an empty location. Just put it here. Okay, we can't do those actions anymore because we don't have any locations lousy with cats. So at the start of the investigation phase, if no locations are lousy with cats, advance. So now we advance. So the Prowling Chaos. You have forced the order's paw. Now their true master, the Prowling Chaos, has emerged. Can you even hope to stop this awful creature? Spawn the set aside Meowlathotep enemy at the central location of your choice. For each Musk enemy in play, attach that enemy face down to Meowlathotep. Now, Meowlathotep is the one who is lousy with cats. Advance to Act 2A and Agenda 2A. So, we get Meowlathotep. It's a 3-fight, 4 health per investigator, and 3 evade. Ancient One Elite Hunter, Meowlathotep gets +1 health for each Musk enemy attached to it, so it has 11 health. Meowlathotep gets +1 fight and +1 evade for every 2 Musk enemies attached to it. While there are 3 or more Musk enemies attached to it, Meowlathotep gains retaliate and alert, so we'll remove these from the game. No, we just put them underneath Meowlathotep. And we spawn it at the central location, so I'll spawn it. Engage with Duke, because I think Duke will start hitting that guy and trying to kill it. Yeah, so, well, let's see. Yeah, we advance this too. So, Meowlathotep's scheme. The Prowling Chaos treads upon the earth once more. It hisses, shakes, and the foundation of, shakes the foundation of the city. It screeches, shatters windows, and rends living creatures whole. It's her. Well, okay, it's her is pretty adorable, but everything else is really bad. Act 2A, the cat and the mouse. There must be a way to destroy this cat abomination for good. Maybe catnip, a cardboard box, a length of string. Spend 1 clue, deal 2 damage to an enemy at your location, or 1 damage without provoking an attack of opportunity. Objective, if Meowlathotep is defeated, advance. Okay, well, we have quite a lot of clues, so I think we'll just have to spend those. So let's see. I think I'll start with Kate, because this is in Kate with Duke. So we'll shortcut in. And we will, no, let's field work in. And then we will play Occult Invocation. I'm also using the Let's see about that. Okay, I'm spending these two cards, so we get plus one. So we are fighting five. Yeah, so we're getting 5, 6, 7 versus 3. Okay, let's see if we can hit. It's a minus 3, so we hit and we deal plus 2, so 3 damage. Let's put a 3 damage counter there. Second action, I'll spend one clue and deal 2 damage. And last action, I'll spend another clue and deal 2 damage. Just take another 3 damage counter here. Okay. So we did 7 damage with 2 attacks. Oh yeah, and let's see. Move, fight, or investigate. So we spent 2 for the movements. Let's see if we get rid of that five Gaia cats. We don't. Okay, so it's Duke's turn. I'll spend one clue. I'll take the attack of opportunity. I'll take 2 here, and 1 horror here, and 1 horror here. And we'll deal 2 damage. So we are at 9. And, sorry, friendly human, but we are spending this, so we'll take 2 damage and... two horror, so... Yeah, let's delete that. So the friendly human is dead. I think he was named Pete. Well, we can find another friendly human. So we deal 2 damage here. So we have 11 damage. So we defeat Meowlathotep. So let's flip this card over. Foiled by dogs. As the entity known as Meowlathotep collapses, its body dissolves into the shadows from whence it emerged. You know that one day the Order of the Dead Rodents on the doorstep will try to revive their master once more. But for now, at least Barkham is safe. You let out a fierce howl to let the rest of the dogs into the city know of your victory. Within moments, the sky is filled with triumphant howls of dogs everywhere. All across Barkham, humans look on in confusion, thinking, why is my dog acting weird? Resolution 1. Resolution 1. The humans will never know the danger that lurked just beyond the edges of their senses. The danger they could not smell despite its foul scent. You will stay alert and loyally sniff out any hazards to your beloved city, for that is the duty and burden you and all dogkind bear. But until the next time you are needed, you are content to sleep, play, and eat treat after treat. Victory is sweet. The investigators win, but only if they too are dog people. Well, I am. Cat people complete the scenario successfully, but feel like traitors. Yeah, well, that was the Barkham Horror scenario, The Meddling of Meowlathotep. I think this is a fun product. I only played these two investigators, so playing with the other three will be quite entertaining. There also was one Musk enemy that was not revealed, because you discard one of them. But I really like this scenario. It looks quite elaborate, but it's quite simple in the end. It doesn't take itself too seriously, so I highly recommend, if you have the chance to grab this, just get it. It's a fun little scenario that you can play and maybe introduce people to Arkham Horror by playing with a not that serious scenario first. So that was Barkham Horror. Thanks for watching, and until next time.